This video resource will cover the techniques for making a knife. We'll be covering the following things: safety factors involved in making a knife, all of the equipment that's involved in it, and then I'll take you through each of the different steps, from forming to shaping, through to hardening, and then into tempering, and finally the finishing phases of attaching handles, testing for sharpness, and then of course putting the blade into action. Before you start any kind of work in a workshop, you want to make sure that you're pretty well protected. In this case, we've got earmuffs, something to protect your eyes, of course gloves to protect your hands, a pair of overalls or some leather coverings, and just remember, if you do get burnt, 20 minutes underwater, just to make sure you get all of that heat out of that affected part. But if you take care, shouldn't happen. Okay, the other really important thing to think about is that a really intense fire is also going to throw out a lot of UV. So again, you do want to keep your arms and your hands and your face protected. We'll start with this. It's an angle grinder, and I've got three different kinds of cutting blades here. The first one, this one, is a really fine one, and that's ideal for making the initial cut in our piece of spring steel. The second one here is just a grinding disc, and the purpose of a grinding disc is, as it says, to remove the metal to create the form or shape. And the third one is a flap disc, and this is really good for doing some initial polishing. Later on, of course, I'll show you how to use the linisher, and that's like a big flat sanding belt to give nice flat surfaces and planes to your tools. This is a heavy 1.8 kg hammer, really essential for moving metal and flattening it out. This is a planishing hammer, which is great for flattening out all the dings and bumps that this one will make. So you need both of those in action. Always important to try to make sure you match up the tong to the piece of steel you've got, so you've got a good, comfortable, firm grip. This is a car spring, usually comes from the front of a car. The last thing we're going to need for making our knives is a furnace. And what we've got here is a gas-fired forge, and that's going to, it's a small box forge, and that will get our temperatures that we need to turn that steel into a lovely golden colour, and that's soft enough for us to shape. The next step is to draw out the design that you've got in mind. When you draw up your knife, you want to make sure that it's actual life size, because you're going to cut that out and use that as the template when you come to the shaping stage. Keep in mind, if you're making a knife for kitchen use on a board, you want to give enough height for your knuckles to fit in underneath. Okay, now we're going to get underway with a little bit of action. First thing we've got to do is cut off a piece of this coil spring. And now we've got to make it into a flat bar. The technique is to hold it by the end, lay it across the face of the anvil, make sure it's at about at least a bright red to an orange. Don't let it get any hotter than that, because if you see little sparks occurring on the side of it, then you know the carbon's starting to come out of it, and we don't want that. At this stage, you're using the heat of the forge to soften the material so that you can shape it. Really important to get that overall shape working. So if we look at a knife here, as it comes from the handle down to the point, we need to be able to see that we're pushing the metal out and flattening that out and making it finer towards the tip. And then likewise, from the back of the blade through to the sharp edge of the blade, we're making sure that there's a very elongated V form happening there as well. In terms of this part here, the handle, you know, the actual shape and pattern of the handle, that's something you can tune up later on with an angle grinder. In this blade, we've done our initial forming, and now it's time for a bit of shaping. The shaping is going to give the finished outline to it, And what we'll need here is the template that we've drawn up and cut out earlier. We draw a profile onto that blade and then we grind it out on the grinder. And that will give us pretty much the final shape. We can also at that stage start to do the linishing, which is to do with flattening out the blade and taking out all of our hammer marks. The next step is going to replace the carbon that we've taken out of it through the heating process. Heat your knife up to about a red heat and then put it into a container of sawdust. That will make sure that the carbon which has been lost during the heating process is going to be brought back into the skin of the steel, making it a good hard blade for sharpening. The blade at this stage is very soft. We've put the carbon back into it and it's ready for hardening. What we have to do is preheat some linseed oil to about 40 degrees Celsius, get our blade up to a nice bright red, and we test it for readiness by grabbing a magnet and putting a magnet against it. If the magnet doesn't stick, we know we've got the right temperature. And then it's quickly into the oil and keep stirring it around for about 20 seconds. The movement makes sure that you've got fresh oil up against the skin of that really hot steel, and it gives an even cooling right across. When you finish the hardening process, take the blade out of the oil, clean it off with methylated spirits, then it's ready for the tempering. Preheat an oven up to 210 degrees Celsius. Put your blade into that and leave it there for half an hour. Turn the oven off, let it cool until you can pick it up, take it out, and that's your first stage of tempering done. For your spring temper, place the edge of the blade between, say, two sheets of metal like so, clamp it in a vise, and then we hold the flame at a point above where the blade in the metal is sheathed in it, and we, as soon as that turns to blue, just start pushing that blue colour along the top, and don't let it come down into where the actual edge is. It shouldn't be allowed to come down that far. Just run it along. It's a bit like painting with a flame torch. This is a piece of jarrah, which is a wonderful Australian hardwood, which makes fantastic handles. This is a piece of manuka and could just as easily be used for making up handles. Any wood, you know, decorative wood, probably more tending towards the harder variety is better than anything too soft. To put the handle onto the knife, we've got a pattern. We go back to the original pattern, look at the shape, make sure you've figured out the kind of handle you want to use. Draw that up and cut it to shape. Get a feel for how that feels when you sort of assemble it. Is it too wide? Is it close? How does the curvature work in your hand? Particularly along the edges, you want to try to make sure you've got those nicely chamfered and smoothed off. I've put a brass rod here. These holes were drilled for those for this particular rod. Cut your length of brass to that shape, and then using a two-part glue that's going to set pretty hard and tough, coat both sides of the wooden handles, put your pins in, squeeze in a clamp, and let that lot set. Then once that's set, grind off, smooth off, sand down to shape and finish. So just remember that this might be your first blade, but I'm sure that once you've got into it, you'll probably want to make a few more. The more you make, the more you tune up into the process.